I'm Sven the Gnat, and here we go with more Let It Die. It has been too long since I've picked this back up. I've been itching to get back to it. I should have sooner, and I'm doing it now, so. And as you can tell, we're back at this screen. Character select. Turns out, that whole first intro segment was just that, an introduction to the game. That was it. Like, all of that was just the tutorial. It was introducing you to how, what the game is, what it's about, everything. And I guess this is where it actually starts, so I get to choose a new character, male or female. I don't know. Yeah. Think I'm gonna go with the same lady I chose last time. We'll go with her. Deborah. Name is Deborah. Okay. No. What's his name coming up on his skateboard this time? Oh, this is different. Last time we went through there. Yeah, through there. Now we're going this way. Oh boy. Yeah, this is where it all gets real. More balloons with notes and instructions. What do you got for me? Waiting room, the hub of your adventure. This is the waiting room of the station Bottom of Barbs. The last stop of line 15, situated under the Tower of Barbs. This room contains many interesting features. Just what are you waiting for, you ask? Perhaps the question should be, what is waiting for you? Oh, shit, that's not good. When you want to quit playing, please select back to title from the options menu when you are in the waiting room. If you quit the game outside of the waiting room, it will be treated as a death. Wow, I gotta remember that. So, back to title. Select back to title when I'm in the waiting room, so I have to get back here before going back to title. If I do anywhere else, shit. Is it dude or chick laying down? I can't tell. Sipping on some whatever. All right. Well, hello to you too. Nice fountain. Splish splash, wading in the water. Oh man, balloons. Hey, you're the chick I give mushrooms to. Stripey. What do you got? Cooking. Ooh, well, don't want an undercooked mushroom. You will encounter mushrooms in the game, so let's take a look how to prepare them. When you cook them, you can cook mushrooms by grilling them. Select the mushroom in your possession you wish to grill. Click the left side of the touchpad to switch to throw mode. In this mode, you can grill the mushrooms by approaching a fire in the stage and pressing X. Some mushrooms cannot be grilled. Oh man, what if, whatever. You can always just throw them into a fire and grill them that way. Their effects change when you grill them, so be experimental with their cooking. All right. Oh shit, wait. Oh, I wanted to look at that. I didn't see what he was that time at the bottom of the note. Mushroom Club. The shop opens after you rescue the Mushroom Magistrate, the owner of the shop. They will deal with skill decals formed from mushroom powder. Okay. What are skill decals? Attaching decals to a fighter's body will benefit the player, so these like tattoos. Like she has, she's got the stripes. Those are her decals. Attaching decals to a fighter's body will benefit the player with various effects. There are many designs and functions. Once a decal is attached, if the fighter dies, or if the decal is removed, it will disappear. That sucks. So if I die, I lose it. If I remove it, I lose it. Purchasing. You can buy skill decals by using kill coins. I want kill coins. Selling. You can... God, this is just a lot of reading. I'm sorry, guys. You can sell skill decals in your possession. Since you can't get rid of them, you may as well sell those you have no use for. Will do. Trading. If you bring the bronze skill shroom, silver skill shroom, or gold skill shroom the magistrate is seeking to the store, he will trade them for skill... Oh, sweet. So if we have any of those bronze, silver, or gold mushrooms, skill shrooms as they're called, I guess, bring them back to this dude once we get the magistrate. Rescue him. Trade him in for good stuff. Mushroom stew. Oh, that's what I want. You can spend kill coins to drink some mushroom stew, which the mushroom magistrate has put... Oh, she's a she. The magistrate didn't want to make... That's probably her on the pole. Duh. Think. Use your fucking head. Put her heart in the making. As a bonus, premium decal is always inside. These decals are different to standard ones. They will not disappear if the fighter they are attached to is killed. Oh, good. So this is what I'm really going to go after. Hello, magistrate. What you doing? You like that umbrella? Cool. I'm gonna talk to you, I guess.
Oh! Oh, how I've been waiting for you, fellow believer, in the power of mushrooms! The secret of my success! The secret of my success! The secret of my success! The secret of your success.
I think I said it before, and I'll say it again. I like her. She's a fun one.
The secret of my success. The secret of my success. The secret of my success!
Alright, shut up. Buy decal, change, buy mushroom. Whoa. I'm assuming I have nothing. That's what it shows in the upper right. You don't got like one freebie? I can't tell what. Okay, I think I may have enough. I don't know why the price numbers are showing in red. Usually that means you don't have enough to buy something, but let's see. Increase attack and defense by 30% when the HP is at 15%. Low. Reduce falling damage. Increase attack. I like that one. That's not bad. Thinking dumbbell. Just simply increase my attack for now. Can we buy it? No, that's what I thought. I don't know why I don't know what I was thinking. Alright.
Come again.
Well, I will. That was a lot of dumb shit. Sorry I had to sit through that. Moving on. Who's this guy? Weapons vendor. Choku Funcha. Commodore Suzuki is a manager of the store. You can give him the blueprints and materials that you find in the tower and ask him to develop equipment from those blueprints and materials. After the equipment has been developed, it can be mass-produced and sold in the store. Finding things to be sold in the store, however, is a player's responsibility. If you have obtained blueprints from the tower in your death bag, when you enter Choku Funsha, Commodore Suzuki will analyze them for you. Thank you. He's a nice gentleman for doing that for me. Purchasing, you can purchase weapons and armor once you purchase. Yeah, we all know how fucking vendors work, don't we? Do I need to really read all this? Let's see. Maybe the R&D. If you gather materials specified by a blueprint, you'll be able to request research and development. On such occasions, you will also require SP lithium obtained by from defeating a specific enemy. Research development will take some time. When the research is finished, that's all it. You know how all this works. He's a rocket now. Rocket man. Of course. We all know how that works. Choku Funcha. Can I buy anything from ya?
Welcome. Our express service is all you need to climb the tower. Bring me the materials and blueprints, and I'll make anything. However, I'll be needing some of your things in return.
Uh-oh.
I use that energy to make the goods. Get it?
Why are you sporting a Hitler stash? And the kind of the same haircut that Kate Blanchett wore in Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. It's weird. I got no money. I got nothing to buy from you. What else is right here? Fucking balloons everywhere. Storage chest. We know those work. Rewards box. Yes. God. I'm assuming this is all the same as, like, generally every other fucking game that has these type of things. Hope I actually didn't skip anything important. Anyway, we've teamed up with the insurance company Direct Hell to offer a special service to support players. It's called DH Service. You can access this and sign up for it in the options menu. Remember, you'll need some of the special currency known as Death Metal. I want some. Sign up, though. Okay. You can buy express passes from the store. You can buy Death Metal from there. Can exchange death metal for kill coins. The exchange rate is 1 death metal to 5,000 coins. Wow. Interesting exchange rate. Do you often shout, I want to climb the tower faster, or I want to play more efficiently? Well, all that can be yours with the purchase of an express pass during using death metal. What? This is going to be fun. After you purchase and use an express pass, the three services below will become available to you for a 30-day period. No money-back guarantee. Once a day, you'll receive a limited decal as a bonus for logging in. Skills have a variety of effects, including increasing HP recovery or your EXP or kill coin gains. You'll be able to use the Royal Elevator. What's the Royal Elevator, you ask? That's what I'm asking myself. Unlike the normal elevator, which requires kill coins to operate, this extraordinary luxury elevator will transport you to your chosen floor of the tower free of charge. So does that mean we can just, like, gain access to this Royal Elevator, go straight to the top of the tower, and be done with this? Probably not. Number of slots in your death bag will increase. These extra spaces are called Royal Slots and will be marked with a crown icon by them. Okay. If you stop using the Express Pass service, the items being held in the Royal Slots, oh sweet, they'll be sent to my rewards box so I don't actually lose them. Cool. Sweet. It's a kind of a pay-to-play service, it sounds like, though. It's probably won't be using it too much. What's this thing? Anything else? Any other balloons? Is this the restroom? Which one am I? Am I red and tied down to a toilet, or blue and tied down to a toilet? Oh, screw it. Oh, these are big bathrooms. There's been a lot of reading, not a whole lot of action going on right now. Sorry. Well, we're gonna get to it, I promise. What's this? Okay, whatever. Clean the fountain. I think we're good now. Let's get go. Finally, you're probably. Yeah. Get the fuck out of here and start chopping shit. Another fucking balloon. Nope. Is that a hot dog cart that's open? It's Uncle Prime. This is a service where Uncle Death will deliver the player presents on his beloved Death Mobile free of charge. It's not just a login bonus, it's Uncle Prime. There's so much to this. Oh my god, my head fucking hurts. Box contents. Contents of boxes are random. You must be excited to find out what's inside. So fling open any box you see. And speaking of boxes, he's a box now. Whoa. Holy shit, Glinty Magnum. Look at the barrel on that motherfucker. Cool. How do I equip it? Death bag. Glinty Magnum. We're gonna put you other. Sure. Rolodex. Whoa. There's so much fucking to this. Hey, is this the dude that was sitting in the background in the end of the last video in the arcade just fucking playing a game? Shit. Good God. There's two. I'll do this off camera. Or not. I'm not on camera. Off recording. In my spare time. Holy fuck, that's too much. Close. A few minutes ago, let's get on with it, and here we are still just reading shit. Oh, this is gonna be like no excitement to this video. Hope you've enjoyed it anyway. God, look at the length and size of that fucking gun. Hangs down to her ankle. That's a big safe. Another one, of course. Not just anybody can gain access. Oh, there we go. Can gain access to the tower. I'm impressed by those doors, man. There's got to be some door manufacturer out there who just struck it big when he was called upon to install those.
Look, there you are from before. The old you is nothing but a raging maniac now. You have to kill him before he kills you.
Oh yeah. You might be kind of confused as to why that's a dude as the old me. Because... that is because I had to replay to get to start, since there was no actual save. That intro. That's how he sends souls to the afterlife, underworld, whatever. Yeah. Didn't mean for it to get confusing with the old me being a dude when he was clearly not a dude in the last video. The first video of this. Haterification. If you fight. God damn, I am done with fucking reading. If fighter exhausts their HP in the game, they will die. He'll be. And will be resurrected as a dead is fun. I like that. Haterification and retrieval. When a fighter dies, it will transform into an enemy roaming about on the floor in which they met their demise. Such fighters are called haters. If you assume control of a new fighter and defeat the hater, they will be retrieved and stored in a fighter freezer. If you let them be and they defeat another player, their rewards will be sent to you. What the fuck, man? There's too much, so much to this. Orange named enemies? This is quite different from... Alright, whatever. All enemies with names displayed in orange are haters. They might be one of your haters or a hater that was once a different player. In either case, they are far stronger than most other enemies you will face. Fucking haters, man. That claw. What the fuck? Ooh. New mail. Hey, I'll take a metal bat. We'll put you there. Yeah, right there. Mushrooms. It's a crush room. Attack up 50% for 30 seconds. I'm gonna store you away for now. I think one of them just farted. Oh no, is that dude? Can you please be the last thing I have to read? Lego, what? Beasts. He's quite the beast. There are a great variety of creatures besides enemies in this game. Not all of them are docile. Some will attack you, others will emit poison. It is important for the player to make use of these beasts in order to survive. How to catch. You press L3, you can crouch. You approach a beast in the stance. The capture beast icon will appear in the bottom center of the screen. When you see the icon, press X swiftly. Some animals can be captured if you're looking for stomping them, eating. I wonder what I want to eat them. Select the eat icon when you catch your beast to eat it. If you choose to store it in your death bag, the number of beasts in your possession will be displayed at the on the flick box at the top right corner of the screen. You can flick on the beast you want to eat with the touchpad. Consume it by clicking on the right side of the touchpad button. Grilling them. Oh my god. I'm not going to remember all of this. I already forget half of it. Already. You can cook them, grill them, anything in your possession. Left side of the touchpad. Throw it on the fire. Or you can hold it over it, okay, also, just like the mushrooms. The same thing as grilling the mushrooms. Mushrooms were, oh wow. The sprout from corpses of any animal that you kill by stomping, or by any other type that grows with any type of animal. Man. Should I kill it, capture it, stomp it? We're gonna capture you, sneak up behind you. Gotcha! Yeah, we're gonna eat you right away. Can level up at the waiting room. Speaking of which, I gotta go back there before quitting the title, otherwise my character dies. And I'll become a hater. I don't want Deborah to become a hater. Drain and money! Kill coins! Alright, who's excited to read another one? Mastery level. If you defeat lots of enemies with a specific type of weapon... Okay, so it's the level... the weapon leveling upgrading system. Maximum level is 20. If you unlock sub moves, you can use with R1 and L1, as well as attack skill boost, acquiring APB, ability points. Ability points will be awarded to the weapon which dealt the final damage in defeating an enemy. Once you accumulate a set number of points, your mastery level will increase. That's what that is. Okay. Mastery LV not dependent on fighter. Mastery level of an APB points acquired are shared between fighters. Even if you switch to a low level fighter, you will still be able to deal attacks correspond. Wow, that's cool. I like that transfer. And by the way, he's a martini now. What the fuck? Look at this thing! Anybody else reminded of Earthworm Jim? Get him, get him. Is that what you're saying? Crouch. I don't need to eat you, because you restore HP, so I'm gonna put you away in my butt. Apparently. What's this? This is new. A page of the Yotsuyama Bionics. Fuck you, balloon. Guess we gotta find out what this one's telling us about stamps this time. Oh no, can't read. Oh crap, I can't. I didn't. Shit. I don't know about stamps now. Because of this dick. Go fuck yourself. Yeah, I'll take a trucker hat. Look at me now. So, is there a way to read about stamps? There is. Here's Barb's Bible. Good God. Wait. Stamps. There's always one stamp station at each level of the tower for Barb's. You can stamp each one once into... What the f... Stamping what? Myself? Stamp station... Stamp section of... Oh, okay. So it's kind of like stamping a passport saying, "Hey, we've been here." It's possible to climb it's without stamping, but you receive some rewards if you do. Oh. So is this what, like, saves? Once you access the stamp station, stamp minigame will begin. Press X with good timing to press in. Pressing falling stamps. It's Tetris now. Are stamps save points, or the fuck is the purpose of this? What's the purpose of the stamp station in general? I'm not getting it. Probably had to held that down, didn't I? Whoops. Oh, I did good. Or is this just like the markers? I don't get that. More earthworm jimmies. Kick this motherfucker. Tried to anyway. Let's see. Oh, I missed. I can do this. Drop kicked. Ew. I will take more kill coins. Yes, I will. Fuck you and your hairspray. Oh, it's not hair. It's like a. Seriously, I thought he sprayed something. She sprayed something. There's an iron. Bits. Give me some bits. Belts and pumps. Belts and salts. Hey, frog. Whoops. Didn't want to do that. I wanted to pick it up and need it for health, but I stumped it anyway. Sorry. I'm gonna put you away. Can't just go around kicking everything you see. Shit. How does this work? Well, there we go. Alright, we're going to crouch. Crouch. Grab ya. Yeah, we'll eat ya. Good frog. Kick it. Money! Alright. So, how do we return to the, that, what was the name of it, where we have to go back to, if we, to quit the title screen, otherwise we die? Because this looks like a good spot to do that at, right? It's the end of this level, we're going up on an escalator. How the fuck do we do that? Deathbag, Underworld, DH. Yeah, if I do back to title now, my character dies right here. I don't want to do that. I don't have to physically run all the way back, do I? Whoops, what'd I do? I just ate that and tear gassed myself. Okay, one more thing. We got a chick. Where was the... I know. Uncle Death wants to talk. Master level. Is there like any way I can fast travel? Good God. What the shit? Yeah, what, the waiting room, was this it? Yeah. Maybe I missed something about trying to get back there. How do we get back to that without physically running all the way back? Yeah, it doesn't say how to get back there. You want to quit playing, just select back to title from the options menu when you're in the waiting room. You want to quit the game outside the waiting room, it will be treated as a death. I don't want to do that. We have to really actually run back to the waiting room? How do we get fucking back there? Oh. Shit. I'll read all that some other time. Huh. Oh, this sucks. I don't want to die every fucking time I quit. Screw it. You know what? Running. Wait, why can't I open you? Am I missing something? I hear one. Oh man, we are not. Oh. Get it quickly, quickly. What is it? Yeah. Never mind, I'm gonna die anyway. Hello?
Are you in pain? Of course, you did die after all. I think dying is pretty awesome, though. I'm sorry. Let me introduce myself. I am in charge of insurance sales in the Tower of Barbs. My name is Kiwako Seto, and I work for Directel Insurance. Many people die in this tower in countless numbers of cruel and unusual ways. And we, at Direct Hell Insurance, are here to support those on the brink of death. Now, allow me to explain our insurance plan for you.
Great. Is that it? Just kidding. Greetings from Hell, Direct Hell's Death Insurance, Dead's most trusted insurance plan. Partner in death. Got lots of rare stuff, just got a new area. Ooh, unexpected beating. Arg, surprise shanking. That cruel and heartless. Game over. Introducing Directel Satisfaction Guarantee. Continue insurance. But wait. Instant coverage. Revive just as soon as you sign up. Satisfaction guaranteed. Beloved items will just be just as you left them. Complete support. Return from the pit of hell all you want. Continue insurance. 3 guarantees. Okay. Special tower barge price one. Super affordable. Okay, how much am I paying? Alright.
But wait! Because this is your first time, there's more! We're offering you an amazing insurance package completely free. Now then, let's bring you back to life, shall we?
Yes, let's. Nice to know Obamacare is working. Wait, why do I look like I do? Oh, there we go. You know what? I think this has gone on really long. Too much reading. But I think this is a good spot to end this episode of Let It Die. I don't care about getting back to, what was it called again? The waiting room? And at quitting because, you know, I don't want to run all the way back there, as it appears to be the only way to do that. Unless I missed something somewhere, if there's some sort of fast travel just to go back. Wait, no! Ah, oh, fuck you. Why can't I switch? That's weird. Okay. I'll take an iron hammer. Replace you. Alright. As I was saying, ending point. End of episode. Thank you for watching. On to the next.